Good afternoon, dear colleagues. First, I would like to thank the organizers of the symposium for this chance to speak at such an important event. And I represent the children's sanatorium called Pionersk, and I'm going to talk about management of healthcare, as I'm not a doctor. We have a state program of development of healthcare in Russian Federation, and one part of the program is international cooperation between Russia and other countries. And there are some international programs that we take part in since 2006. Sanatorium made an agreement about cooperation with a Polish organization. It is called the Partnership Agreement, and within the framework of this agreement, we are leading five international programs aimed at improvement of health of our kids and some improvement in the system of healthcare. Nowadays, our organization is carrying out a large-scale project called the Program for Prevention of Posture Defects in Children. And it is granted by Poland, and we received this grant for several years. According to the World Health Organization, the condition of kids is getting worse, and the scoliosis and posture defects is one of the most important causes of these problems in health. In Russia, about 40% of children suffer from postural disorders, and nearly 9% from scoliosis. As for Poland, the number of those who have the disorder of their posture is up to 60%, and those who have scoliosis is 5 to 9%. Taking into consideration the fact that the official statistics consider just those patients who come to see the doctor, we can see, we can deem that the real, actual level of this disorder is higher. Nowadays, if we manage to diagnose scoliosis at an early stage, we are able to stop it and prevent it from development. According to data of Kazan Institute, Medical Institute, if nothing is done and scoliosis is progressing in 50 or 60% of cases, this person becomes a disabled person. According to research, we got data that the costs for treatment of scoliosis is very high, as you see, from 8,000 to 35,000 euros. This figure may be even higher today, because this is the figures of 2010. Conservative treatment of scoliosis of first, second, and third type make up to 7,000 euros. Oh, sorry, I confused some data. So operative treatment is the first group. It's from 8,000 to 35,000, and this also results in costs for handicapped, for disabled people. And conservative conservative treatment, which includes the shalom braces and other equipment, it makes up to 7,000 euros. And these figures lead us to the conclusion that the program of our project is justified from the social and healthcare point of view. Unfortunately, nor in Russia, neither in Russia nor in Poland, there is no state program for degrees, for reduction of scoliosis, or for early diagnosing of this disease. And that's why we wrote this program of prophylactics of posture disorders and scoliosis. We call it a comprehensive program because it has two units. One unit is treatment and the other and diagnostics. So one is treatment and the other is diagnostics. As for diagnostics, we do screening of kids in the Kaliningrad oblast and in the town of Mazur in Poland. 8,500 people were screened, and we try to detect scoliosis at early stages, and we also detect impaired posture. We made a microbus equipped with medical equipment. We use plantograph and tomograph equipment and electroneuromyograph, and we can do some preliminary assessment on the spot, and this is non-invasive equipment, so this is not harmful impact. The team consists of a doctor, traumatologist from Russia, two physiotherapists from Poland, and the medical secretary from either country, depending on where it's taking place. We can say that methods used at diagnosing are similar both in Russia and Poland, and the interpretation methods are also similar. Doctors have sessions every month, so screening takes 1 week, and the other 3 weeks of the month are devoted to processing of data. In 1 month, the laboratory observes about 100 children a day, and we have a 5-day working week. We chose some schools in the village, and thus children from 4th to 8th grade come to be observed, and if there are more children in this school, then the laboratory, the mobile laboratory, stays there for a longer time. We picked 4th to 8th grade children because before 10 to 11 years, it is very rare that children have scoliosis, and after the 8th grade, normally if someone has the scoliosis, it is already detected and there is no point for early screening. We also developed and installed an electronic medical system, an electronic database. We input data of the diagnosing from Russia and from Poland. And this data in the database enable us to keep track of these patients and stay in contact with them. We will be able to make some statistic investigation and monitor the villages, the territories that we are working in. Okay, so first, personal data of a kid are input in the database, and the contact information is also input. The electronic database gave a unique number to these children, and a stripe code is given to each children, which is used at all consecutive tests. All the equipment, all the pieces of equipment use the code, and so we do it without using personal data, but just the code. Children pass through topography procedure, optical topography, and the parameters are reflected in the electronic database. At default, the system records all the data, and the doctors don't have to write it by hand. If it's null, all the data is there, but if there are some deviations, then the doctor has to put some information in. Electromyography has not been used by us. At the final stage, a kid is diagnosed, and this diagnosis stays in the electronic system. I can say that this system, electronic system, has a big potential, and it confirms some statistical observation, tracing different indicators, and all these indicators can be traced by age or by location. As for the other treatment and prophylactics module that we do, children who are diagnosed with scoliosis are sent to sanatorium in the Russian Federation or in Poland at the cost of the project. Approximately the number of kids diagnosed with scoliosis is expected to be 15%, that is about 1,200 people. Kids diagnosed with other disorders of locomotor apparatus will be sent to other institutions and will receive treatment funded by the state, and in Poland they will also be sent to institutions, medical institutions, and will be paid for. After some group of kids from school is tested, the rector gets information about pupils of his or her school. As of today, nearly 3,000 school children have passed through tests. In the Kaliningrad region of Russia, we tested more than 1,000 people, and the average age of kids was 14, with girls, and 12.9 with boys. Posture disorder made up to 55%, grade scoliosis was 0.4%. Locomotor pathology was detected with 42%. And you can see that this spinal pathology was of different types. Feet pathology was also detected in Armenian Masurian implant. The similar number of children was observed, even more. And here you can see the figures. For example, first grade scoliosis is more than 50%. Third and grade scoliosis was not detected. Pathology of locomotor operators was detected with more than 30%, spinal pathology 22%. And you can see types of these spinal pathologies broken down. Today we can say that our project has been carried out, and we compared the condition, the health condition of school children in Russia and Poland, and we can see that the incidence of disease is higher than official statistics. It means that it is very important to do what we tried to within our project, that children have to be diagnosed, and it's also important that kids who were diagnosed will receive treatment at the cost of the project budget. And we also trying to create an efficient structure between Russia and Poland, and between the countries. Большое спасибо за эту презентацию. Есть какие-либо вопросы или комментарии? Да, пожалуйста.
Виктор Печерский. В рамках вашей программы, как организована работа
How do you organize work with kids and their families? So, you receive a lot of information concerning each kid, and how do you work with his or her families? Well, in the framework of this screening, we do not work with families. We cooperate with schools, and school nurse, and school director. They classes, big groups of kids that will be examined. And we use personal data in very limited amount. We mostly use computerized data, digital, and all equipment. All equipment uses the unique number, unique code, and we do not work directly with families. Children just get the results of tests. Either it is a diagnosis or just a notification that his or her kid has passed through tests. Есть еще вопросы? So what was the time frame and the budget? The budget is 2 million euros and the time frame is 2 years. And the grant, it is 2007, 2013, it's funded by the European Union, and about 20% of the budget is given by the Russian Federation. We are using the geopolitical position, and we fall under this European Union programs. So.
Курс стандартный, соответственно, стандартами Российской Федерации и Республики Польша. У нас 21 гривен.
So there was a question about the treatment, how many days is that, and the answer is that it is standard for the Russian Federation and for Poland. Normally it's 3 weeks. And during the project we are planning to give treatment to all kids that are diagnosed during our screenings. Is there any network of children's orthopedists? There are very few, and that's why you know, we picked small towns and cities for our program because children from those small villages often don't have access to orthopedic observation and treatment. We didn't aim at observing just those kids who have never been to an orthopedic doctor. And sometimes we come across those who have received some treatment. We work with schools, and so those who study there they become members of the program. What is the percentage of kids who have been diagnosed with scoliosis and who become members of your program? We do not track that. We don't track that. We just diagnose scoliosis ourselves, and we count the number of these children.
У нас немного времени, поэтому, может быть, какой-то короткий вопрос есть?
Ну, первый вопрос, наверное. На бумажном носителе ребенку заключение выдается...
Is there any document, conclusion of a doctor printed out and given to a child, the kids? Is anything handed? Yes, the result of computer diagnosis and conclusion of traumatologist and orthopedic doctor, and also this document that makes it possible to go to some state medical institution to be treated. What equipment do you use for computer pantography? And what about stability? Both pantography and stabilometry, we bought a new AMB brand equipment. Are you planning to spread your project to other territories? Yeah, we are planning to do it in the Leningrad region, in the St. Petersburg region. And we are planning to conduct screenings wider.